drown her, even more mangled. Drowner corpses lying around. Hunter's gotta be one powerful beast. This is getting old. Some overgrown brute murdered a whole swarm of drowners. This is getting old. Some overgrown brute murdered a whole swarm of drowners. seen one this big in a while. Gotta be ancient. Something tells me it got a little angry. Abode. As long as I'm here, I might as well look around. A letter? Troll looked to be pretty good with his hands, but I'd never suspect he could write. Plan of attack for the fortress. Not how I remember it. Guess our friends must have trapped the owner of these drowners before we could reach the fortress.
Geralt had to face Aradin, but could only hope to beat him with the help of friends. The Wild Hunt could be defeated with exceptionally powerful magic, so Triss and Yen set out to reconvene the Lodge of Sorceresses. Avalach, too, began to lay plans of his own.
Here to talk about the contract.
Contract? Ah, yes. Put my mark to something of the sort. Seems a creature's attacking lonely passers-by, abandoning their corpses in gutters around Oxenfurt.
Isn't that something you should look into?
Perhaps, but we've a ploughing war to win. Haven't got the time to clean gutters.
I'll take the job. Need to hear some details.
You'll learn everything I know.
Like to examine the victim's bodies.
A corpse is a corpse.
I see the wounds. Might be able to tell what kind of monster killed them.
Ask our Sawbones. He'll know if the corpses have been burned or not. You'll most likely find him in the hut on the riverbank, our impromptu morgue.
Any witnesses to these attacks? Anyone see the beast?
Some woman survived an attack. They say she's not been sober since. I'd try the tavern in Oxenfurt if you're willing to try talking to her.
Won't give me any trouble with the reward, will you?
Nah, I want this out of my hair.
Oh, will you buy a round for a victim of the beast?
Tell me about the monster. How you were attacked.
I'd need another bottle to get through it.
See, I'd rather you stayed sober while we talked. Bought yourself that bottle later.
Have it your way. I was leaving the inn that night. Might have had a drink or five. But I'm sure I wasn't hallucinating. Something down an alley called my name. It was dark. Couldn't see what it was, but it wasn't no human. Of that I'm certain.
What makes you so sure?
I just know. This thing grabbed the hem of my skirt, but I broke free and ran.
That it? You didn't see much.
Don't believe me either, do you? Fuck you! Fuck you all!
Such excellence. My, my.
That Nilfgaardian Emperor can kiss my ass. Ooh!
Beg your pardon.
Where is the fatherland?
They found another corpse yesterday. Drained to the last drop. Not an ounce of blood left. Skin and bones. Blast! Out of here!
Streets aren't safe no more.
White Wolf.
I won't talk with you.
A bracelet. pretty worn. Silver under the gilding. Too big for a woman's wrist. Attacker lost it, most likely.
Redania. Long live Exit.
If you were an ordinary...
You the medic? I'd like to see the monster's victims.
Oh, yes. I've not had them burned yet. Must get to that.
You done autopsies yet? Intend to?
Why would I? Beggars and vagrants. Every last one stinking of cheap wine.
Mind if I have a look?
In point of fact, I'd prefer you didn't sniff around.
Gonna make me come back with a written order?
Good grief. Pushy, aren't we? Here, the key to the morgue. Look all you want. Stitch red to red, yellow to yellow, and white to white. That ain't funny. If you were an ordinary man, I'd diagnose anemia. But you?
He was drunk. Someone dragged him over the cobblestones. Fang marks on his neck. Vampire sucked his blood. Vampire bites and the strong stench of alcohol. Just like the other one. Fondness for jewelry? Wounds on the victims' bodies. Everything suggests a catacan. Except this vampire likes the blood of drunkards. That's the way to lure it out.
Honor in the fatherland.
Believe me either, do you?
They'll hear you.
Fuck you!
Oh, I remember you. What'll it be?
Wanna get drunk off my ass, and it's gotta be on cheap wine.
Trouble with the lass, or did your enterprise go under?
Neither. Just part of the job.
I'll need you to pay in advance.
More. And keep it coming.
Redania.
Once was a maid from Vicar Varro. Tight at night, she'd be loose come morrow. Early in the morning,
for you know
another maid from Vicar Varro, plowed with pleasure and drank with sorrow, till early in the morning.
Long live Exit.
Catacan didn't hear it. I'll try another verse.
You'll choke to death on 3 pounds of steel.
Our third maid was not demanding. Gave it up to any man standing early in the morning.
What's the meaning of this? Such rudeness and vulgarity, young people these days.
All right, all right. Sheesh.
Long live Radovid!
I sense your blood.
Come out and fight, bitch.
I shall drink your blood.
Come on, cut the shit.
Here I am. Over here.
Found another corpse yesterday. Drained to the last drop. Not an ounce of blood left. Skin and bones.
Blast! Streets aren't safe no more.
Ah, you got nothing to fear. Haven't you heard? Please don't.
I can hear it. Way to go. It's going to the hut by the river. Killed the monster that was murdering folk. Turns out a catacan was prowling the city.
You speak true. But what on earth's a catacan?
A higher vampire. Particularly interesting case, this one.
How the hell could a foul beast be interesting?
This one liked alcohol. Had a hugely inflated ego, too.
What matters is you snuffed it out. Due some praise for that, Witcher.
So long.
I'd give you a discount for heroic deeds, but the madam...
No strong cards, no gold king. shan't be entering. Yes?
Heard you play for high stakes here.
Firstly, we must have the proper effects. Let's have a look at our cards, shall we? Cards are in order, but can we afford the buy-in?
We can.
Well, let's have a name then, and we shall issue an entry ticket.
Geralt of Rivia.
Gerard of Rivia. The match will start soon, but the hoi polloi must first be driven out. We will please wait. Achoo! Tournament participants only. Everyone else out. Achoo! We are cordially invited to come back tomorrow.
Well, well. Geralt of Rivia. And I was beginning to think this tournament would be a dreadful bore. I'm afraid winning coin from peasants, thugs, and faux aristocrats is no great source of satisfaction for me.
We know each other?
Let's say we've some mutual acquaintances. I've heard many good things about you. In vivid detail.
Place like this, that's more a warning than a recommendation. What's your name?
Sasha.
Sasha what? Or maybe just skip right to telling me your real name.
Place like this, Sasha will need to suffice.
Come to the Passiflora often? Seem to know everyone.
I'm here from time to time. I cannot say all the faces are familiar, but that is Patrick Hazelnut. Never goes anywhere without those three.
Met a man once who traveled with two Zerikanian warrior women as bodyguards. But those three
have other talents, clearly. The halfling's Bernard Tully, a farmer, claims to play for pleasure. But everyone wants to win, don't they? Best beware of that one. He's not particularly fond of others, outcasts, types like you. Ironic, since Phineas himself is a half-elf. And I'm certain you've heard of Count Tybalt. After all, he is the one who organized this tournament.
Actually, I haven't heard of him.
He's reputed to be fabulously wealthy. I can't say how true it is, but he was able to afford his title and the county that came with it.
All right. See you later, Sasha.
Try to chat up the other players before the tournament begins. We must all wait for Count Tybalt anyway.
I'm bored.
Eternal fire!
You
mute, I wish you health.
Eternal fire.
Yes.
I'm new to this too. Took me ages to squirrel away the coin for the buy-in. Mushrooms are no quick route to riches.
You really a farmer?
Why not look it? Got a little farmstead just outside the city. Could sit there for days just watching things grow.
What's with the smell?
The smell? Anywho, mushrooms are all well and good, but one's got to get away at times. My lady, she was in tears, said I'd get my throat slit in Novigrad. But I says to her, I says, Hortensia, what a chance. The best players, the rarest cards. She had to let me go.
Good luck to you.
Likewise. Now, that's the sporting spirit. Not like that half-elf over there who's been shooting me murderous glares this whole time.
I'm bored stiff.
What?
Playing tournaments often?
What are to you? Perhaps you'd wish to see my cards as well. Am I a hee-haw for you to fondle before you choose? Shall I wag my prick for you?
See your cards when we play.
You're unlikely to advance that far, mutant.
I'm bored. Mutant.
Apologies, but I must focus my thoughts before the match.
I can see that.
This will certainly serve me better than your conversation with Sasha has served you. I'd be wary of her.
My board stiff.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to our closed Gwent tournament. By closed, I mean more than the mere elite nature of the event. Anyone leaving the Passiflora before the end of play will be disqualified. That's rule number one. Rules number two, three, and four are no fighting, dirty play, or magic tricks. We play for golden figurines. The winner will take them all, along with a monetary prize equal to 9 times the buy-in. Easy enough to calculate that 9 have entered. The tournament will consist of 3 rounds. The finalist emerging from said shall play me. Players will be paired by random draw. The groupings for the first round shall be read now.
Achoo! Phineas and Tim Knott. Patrick Hazelnut and Harold Featherbuns. Gervalt of Rivia and Bernard Tull.
How about that?
Bramble Frontenstock and... Madam Sasha.
Excellent.
A pleasant match to you all.
Ooh. Starting at last. A year down the road, I'll be plying Hortensia and my lads with tales of this night. Let's play! You would have thought?
So, how did you fare in the first round?
Tournament's over for me, I'm afraid.
Not necessarily. I have a proposition for you.
All right.
Geralt had to face Aradin, but could only hope to beat him with the help of friends. The Wild Hunt could be defeated with exceptionally powerful magic, so Triss and Yen set out to reconvene the Lodge of Sorceresses. Avalach, too, began to lay plans of his own.
You copper, look, you got a pie.
Oh.
Starting at last. A year down the road, I'll be plying Hortensia and my lads with tales of this night. Let's play!
So, how did you fare in the first round?
Tournament's over. All right.
Geralt had to face Aradin, but could only hope to beat him with the help of friends. The Wild Hunt could be defeated with exceptionally powerful magic, so Triss and Yen set out to reconvene the Lodge of Sorceresses. Avalach, too, began to lay plans of his own.
Just a bit more. I'll drop this job.
Starting at last. A year down the road, I'll be plying Hortensia and my lads with tales of this night. Let's play! Congratulations. Bit of a shame being eliminated in the first round, but so it goes. Tis only a game. Having a good time. That's what matters.
So, how did you fare in the first round?
Not bad. Guessing you won too.
I've the distinct impression my opponent was drunk. Had an altogether decent hand, but...
might have had a hard time concentrating.
Care to finish this conversation in private? I've a proposition for you. Meet on the terrace upstairs.
All right.
I've a wild art. Care to tame me?
I was made for loving.
Alone at last.
What did you want to talk about?
A cartload of coin. That's the grand prize, you know. I can't speak for you, but I'd prefer it didn't land in the wrong hands. And luck can be so undependable. Frankly, one should simply take the coin, subtly, you know, without bothering the others.
Why tell me?
I'm a woman. I'm in need of that coin. And Geralt of Rivia would never abandon a woman in need, or so I heard.
Who'd you hear it from?
Fringilla Vigo. She told me of your adventures in Beauclair. Apparently you're dependable, so long as the cause is just.
Doesn't seem like a just cause to me.
What if I told you my life depended on it?
That changes things. Fine. Let's say I help you.
I'll split the coin with you, of course.
Split? What if I win the tournament?
I shall have another proposition for you then.
What's the plan?
I shall tell you all when the time is right. For now, just stay alert. And if you are eliminated, stay till the tournament's end. It'll be worth your while. You'll see.
All sounds pretty mysterious, but fine.
Excellent. Now that's settled, let's rejoin the others.
So pretty, but he can't keep his hands off himself.
Time for round two. Your attention, please.
Madame Sasha and Gilbert of Rivia. Phineas and Harold Featherbuns.
We wish you a pleasant match. May fortune smile on you always.
Ooh, Geralt the Monster Slayer. I've a wild art. Care to tame me? Won't find any better. From the Yoruga.
I get no pleasure whatsoever from easy victories, so I should be very angry if you let me win.
Don't plan to. Curious about that other proposition, though. Congratulations.
I like men who know how to lose. You remember our deal, right? You will stay till the tournament's end.
Yes. Promised to help, didn't I?
Congratulations, madame. A superb match. Did you expect to be victorious, my lady?
Yes, I had a good feeling about the tournament.
Thief! The coin's gone. The guard's been stabbed.
What?
How is this possible?
No one's removed the coin from the premises. All those leaving were searched.
Phew!
We must scour the building. Anyone leaving must pass inspection.
Before you ask, it wasn't me.
Figured as much.
You promised to help me. I say we try to recover the coin together.
Agreed. Where do we start?
We must get upstairs. Wait. I say, this Witcher is Captain Hansen's good friend. He could examine the crime scene. Charge only a trifling.
A fee? But...
We will, of course, collect it from the captain personally. How is his injury from the other week? Has it healed yet?
Well, I'd heard it had.
Splendid. We shall go upstairs at once.
Geralt had to face Aradin, but could only hope to beat him with the help of friends. The Wild Hunt could be defeated with exceptionally powerful magic, so Triss and Yen set out to reconvene the Lodge of Sorceresses. Avalach, too, began to lay plans of his own.
Quite a smile, like a raw wound.
Ooh, Geralt the Monster Slayer. Otherwise,
we wish you a pleasant match. May fortune smile. Time for round two. Your attention, please.
Madame Sasha and Gilbert of Rivia. Phineas and Harold Featherbuns. Phew!
We wish you a pleasant match. May fortune smile on you always.
Won't find any better. From the Yoruga to the Dragon Man.
I get no pleasure whatsoever from easy victories. So I should be very angry if you let me win.
Don't plan to. Curious about that other proposition, though.
Well, I hope your luck holds.
Ladies and gentlemen, the third round. The heat is on.
The nearest round's winner will face Count Tybalt himself in the final. Phineas and Gerard of Rivia.
Achoo!
Are not player muted.
Are we to understand you forfeit this round? Fine. In that case...
No, I'm not swiving forfeit the round. I shall squash him like a louse.
A good match to you both. Please remember the tournament rules. No magic, no quarrels.
Play. cheated! I'll gouge those devilish eyes out with my bare hands!
The monster slayer. I'm a wild art. Care to time me?
Well played. Congratulations on both your victories. I'd wanted to summon the guards initially, but...
Yeah, it's better I took care of it.
Please, join me for the final. I must admit I did not expect this outcome. Bet a rather large sum on another player, in fact.
Might have guessed there were multiple games going on.
He's so pretty, but he can't keep his hands off himself.
Let's begin. superb match. A great pleasure. The prize will be yours.
Thief! The coin's gone. The guard's been stabbed.
What?
How is this possible?
No one's removed the coin from the premises. All those leaving were searched.
Phew!
We must scour the building. Anyone leaving must pass inspection.
Before you ask, it wasn't me.
Figured as much.
An unexpected turn of events, but our agreement stands. We must try to recover the coin together.
Agreed. Where do we start?
We must get upstairs. Wait. I say, this Witcher is Captain Hansen's good friend. He could examine the crime scene. Charge only a trifling.
A fee? But...
We will, of course, collect it from the captain personally. How is his injury from the other week? Has it healed yet?
Well, I'd heard it had.
Splendid. We shall go upstairs at once.
Next time we see the captain, m'lady, I'd appreciate your mention.
That is all, good fellow. You may go. The Witcher requires absolute silence while he works.
Of course. That went well. Really know the captain?
Yes, a horrid man. Come now, get to work.
Blows delivered from a strange angle. Expert, though. Precise. Somebody dragged something heavy towards the terrace. Crossbow bolt. A line tied to it. Line's clearly been cut.
Thief might have used it to lower the sack of coin. He'd need an accomplice waiting down below to grab it.
Something down there, but I can't make it out. Must have been one of the players. Lowered the coin down on the line, then strolled past the guards.
This was well prepared. Think you can track the culprit down?
Don't know yet. I'll look in the street, see if I can find anything there. Come on. Same as the one tied to the bolt. Gonna have to look around. Where's that scent coming from? Cinnamon. Strange.
I don't smell a thing.
It's done. It's done.
Haste makes waste. Cooper had lost this crate. Must have fallen off the wagon.
Can you be certain this was the thief's?
Crossbow under the packages. Itching to crack a pun about every rosemary having its...
I appreciate you resisting the impulse. I've seen this guild mark. It's a trading company's. One that imports spices from Zerikania. They have a storehouse at the docks. Northernmost one on this side of the port. Shall I meet you there?
Sounds good.
There are six inside. I wasn't able to get the door open.
Gotta find another way in then. Which one's Hortensia?
The tall one.
Masquerade's done, Tully. Give us the coin.
Masquerade? Well put. Been watching you from the start, sweetheart. Though I ought to admit, I thought you'd follow me alone. Told him who you are yet? No? I'm sure he'd love to hear it. Go on, tell him. Or I'll tell Hortensia to break your fingers.
What's this about?
It's about Madame Sasha swallowing my mushroom farming nonsense hook, line and sinker when she should have been more vigilant. So, will you tell him who you spy for? Or would you rather scream it out?
Let go of her. Step away.
One of you restrain him, then make sure he gets a good view.
That's enough of that.
Good work. I did not, in fact, suspect him, whereas he clearly caught on to me long ago.
Halflings can be unpredictable.
At any rate, we've succeeded. Now to divide the coin.
Oh yeah. So what's this proposition that's supposed to convince me to share my winnings?
No longer on the table. We retrieve the coin together. We shall divide it equally. Know what? Let's have dinner at the Kingfisher. My treat. To celebrate my last day in Novigrad.
Heading back to Nilfgaard? That why you needed the coin?
I see you miss very little.
Still got a touch of an accent.
Ah well. It seems I shall need a new trait. Anyway, I'm compromised in Novigrad, so...
Who were you before you became a spy?
I don't rightly remember anymore. But I suppose you can call me Cantarella.
That your real name?
Well, almost.
I'd love to. As it turned out, the blue-eyed prostitute was actually his sister. He couldn't believe it.
Oh, my.
He asked me to see her again at the House of the Night, and then...
Fascinating story. Shall we go upstairs? You can show me exactly how it ended.
Great idea.
Oh.
Slipped away without a word.